If you think that Survival Heroes is a pay-to-win game, you have either not been playing long enough or you are really bad at the game. If the latter applies to you, I recommend checking out my video with 131 tips and tricks for Survival Heroes. I spent dozens of hours on that video compiling beginner, intermediate, and advanced tips to help you play at the maximum level. If you're in the former group, this video was made for you. While it is true that you can speed up your progress in the game by spending money, which does give a slight advantage to pay-to-win players in the beginning, a free-to-play player can get everything a pay-to-win player can buy in only a few months. And once you get what you need to perform at the max, you get to keep it forever, and then no one will ever have an advantage over you again. Okay, so there are three main things you need to get in order to have the best advantage on the battlefield. The first one is a skin. Having a skin requires people to click here to identify your loadouts, and they let you start out with 7 backpack slots instead of 5. These might seem like small advantages, but any advantage is still an advantage. Now, as you play, you will get lots of temporary skins, which helps for a while, but ultimately you will want to get a permanent skin. The fastest way to do this is to collect 28 skin shards. The best way to get skin shards is to complete the collection event, which gives you 10 skin shards along with several other amazing prizes. This does require you to be pretty active if you want to get all of the achievements done in time, but it is very much worth it. The second best way to get skin shards is to invite at least one player to the game and get them to input your code here, which will of course require you to give them your code, which you can find here. After you get that one person, it will unlock new quests for you and them. Those quests give lots of rewards, and they are the best way to get skin shards quickly. If any of you are having trouble convincing your friends to play this game, I've actually made a short 2-minute video designed specifically for you to share with your friends to try and convince them to join you. But if you don't have any friends, or our combined efforts cannot persuade them, then you can still get a skin by collecting 300 exchange shards, which you can earn by watching 300 commercials. So I would recommend finding a friend, but it is technically a free way to do it. The second thing you need to do is unlock all of the weapons. Not having access to all of the weapons will make it harder to find a starting weapon and limit your possibilities at the end of the game, since some weapons are really strong counters to other weapons. Luckily, unlocking all of the weapons is really easy to do as a free-to-play player. If you are an active player, you can easily unlock all of the weapons in less than a month, which is really good because it costs almost $5 for each weapon you want to unlock by spending money. Now, if you're not strictly a free-to-play player, and you spend just $1 on the game, the devs reward you by giving you the Fogblade, Snow Spear, and Manual, which is a crazy good deal. And personally, I think it's good to support the devs at least $1 if you like their game and want them to keep developing it. Alright, so the last thing you need to get is 27 level 5 runes and 3 level 5 glyphs that perfectly complement your playstyle. Having a perfect rune set is not that big of an advantage when comparing it to a player's skill level, but any advantage is still an advantage, so you want to be able to get the best setup possible. This is where the most people have accused the game of being pay to play. Ironically, this is also where the game has copied League of Legends almost exactly, and very few people accuse League of Legends of being pay to win. I think the reason for this is because those people have not played long enough and assume that pay to win players are getting more of an advantage than they actually are. While it's true that a player can spend money to buy runes at random, pay to win players are more limited than you might think, and free-to-play players are given more options than you might think. A player can't actually use all of their runes until they hit level 30. Even though the game has been out for over a month, not a single player has hit level 30. This is because there is a cap on how much experience you can get each week, and that cap is the same for pay-to-win and free-to-play players. After the 2 months it takes to hit level 30, a free-to-play player, if he is talented at the game and wise with his gold, diamonds, guild tokens and rune shards, then he will be able to get at least all level 4 runes, and if he's lucky, most of them will already be level 5. Now, I already gave you some tips on the most efficient way to spend your guild tokens to get runes in my video about guilds, but let me touch briefly on these other resources. Gold is the easiest resource to get. An active free-to-play player should easily be able to get 10,000 gold a day. Now, in the first month, you will probably spend most of this on weapons, which is great, but by the second month, you should have most of the weapons and will be able to spend all of it on rune drops. Diamonds are the second easiest resource to get. You get tons and tons of diamonds at the end of the season by achieving higher ranks. You also get a ton of diamonds from your guild's rank, which I also explain in that video. If you are a free-to-play player, do not spend your golden diamonds as soon as you get them. Towards the end of each season, or maybe the end of each month, I'm not sure yet because the game is so new, the game will discount all rune draws by 25%. Save all of your extra gold that you don't use on the guild quest and all of your diamonds for when these are discounted. This will let you buy hundreds and hundreds of runes. After buying all of those runes, go to the exchange button in the obtain tab and disassemble all of your unneeded runes for rune shards. Do not spend these rune shards. Rune shards are the most important resource for you to use well if you are a free-to-play player because they are the only way to choose the exact rune you are wanting. If you use rune shards early, then you might randomly get that same rune when you no longer need it. So to use rune shards most efficiently, you want to wait until you have enough rune shards to finish a set. This requires patience and self-control, but if you are a free-to-play player, you should be familiar with making sacrifices for the sake of maximizing what is available to you. I also recommend choosing a rune set that is versatile so it can benefit you with lots of different types of weapons, but I will talk about that more in my video about runes. Now, eventually you will want to have a second, third, fourth, and fifth rune page, which will take you a long time or cost you thousands of dollars, but that is part of the fun of MOBA games. They keep coming out with new weapons and new pieces of gear, and we will want to try out new types of rune combinations to go with them, which will keep the game fun and fresh and make it to where we always have new goals that we are shooting for. Well, that's it guys, hope that helps. My wife, Eowyn, and I will be doing a live stream of Survival Heroes together soon, and it should be a lot of fun. I have more details in the pinned post, so make sure to check that out. Alright guys, I'll see you next time.